Mike. And this is all Wild and Life. The Devil's Rope, or barbed wire, the invention that came to the West. And it came about in the late 1800s as ranchers moved out onto the plains and they needed to fence their land against other farmers and ranchers. Railroaders throughout the West needed to keep livestock off the tracks, and farmers needed a way to keep cattle from trampling their crops. Joseph Glidden received his patent for what is now considered modern barbed wire in 1874 and began promoting it in Texas. Before the fences, the West was open range. Cattle allowed to roam freely, regardless of who owned the land. The invention and use of barbed wire brought plenty of drama to Western rangeland. It made fencing of huge expanses cheaper than hiring cowboys to keep track of your cattle. And in the 1880s, the government, on large ranches with governmental toll, began fencing public and federal lands without any regard to land ownership or other public needs such as mail delivery, or the path that ranchers took to move livestock from one grazing area to the next. This led to the fence cutting wars, which broke out in Wyoming in the early 1880s, and until 1883, when a court ordered big cattle companies to stop fencing public lands and remove fences that they had built. Nonetheless, by the 1890s, barbed wire fencing was everywhere, and the age of the open range was gone. Wyoming is still an open range state, some call it a fence out state. Basically, all that means is that if you don't want my cows on your property, it's your responsibility to build and maintain a fence. Livestock still have the right of way around here. If an animal is hit and killed, the driver of a vehicle is liable and could end up paying the price of the animal and the repair to the damage to the vehicle. And if the county or state doesn't want cows crossing the highway or road, it's their responsibility to build and maintain a fence there as well. In some cases, the state has even built tunnels underneath highways for cattle to move through.
All this leads to this week's project, fencing off the dump. Every rancher around here has a dump, whether it's spread out over the entire ranch or confined to one area like ours. The dump is full of old wood, old equipment, and materials, and because most ranchers and farmers never throw anything away, you never know when you might need to salvage a part off an old mower, and it lives here. But the dump is also a hazard to animals. Cows are curious, and a cow or a calf could get tangled up in old wire or cut themselves on a piece of metal. This year, we will be breeding our heifers, or cows that have not yet had a calf, in this pasture. The pasture that also includes the dump. Fencing off the dump will allow the cows to be safe, as well as allowing us to preserve the dump and its contents. New fences always start with planning. Thanks to tools that past generations never had, we get to do this quite easily. Where in the past they had to measure on site, we can use Google Earth to plan our layout and figure out our materials for the project. Then, we go to the actual site and transfer the layout. The most important part and most time-consuming part of a barbed wire fence is constructing the corner and bracing posts. Barbed wire is under a lot of tension, often up to 1,000 pounds, and the corner post's sole function is to resist the tension of the fence connected to it, and bracing keeps the corner post vertical and prevents any slack in the fence. After we finish this fence, we will be moving our heifers into this pasture, and a new bull will be arriving within a few days to start breeding, so we will be setting our corner posts in concrete. This allows them to be stronger, faster. Posts are 6 to 8 inches around and 8 feet long. Using the bobcat and an auger attachment, we can drill holes in the earth up to 3 feet deep and set the posts vertically, making sure it's level and straight. We place another post, known as the brace post, about 4 feet from our corner post and add a horizontal compression brace, this one made out of 2.5-inch steel pipe, connecting the two posts. Then, a diagonal wire connects the top of the brace post to the bottom of the corner post. This wire prevents the post from leaning, which then allows the horizontal brace to prevent the corner post from leaning, keeping the whole corner square and solid. Line posts are then installed, spacing them 16 feet apart. Our line posts are steel T-posts that are 5 feet long and driven into the ground using a T-post pounder, a 40-pound tool that we slam down on the post to drive them into the ground. This is a good time to introduce Mitch. Mitch is our hired hand for the summer. He just graduated high school and will be leaving for Army basic training in August. He has helped out here on the ranch for the last few months, but this is his first big project. Say hi, Mitch. As luck would have it, I only own one T-post pounder. So Mitch will get the honor of pounding around 100 T-posts that need to get put into the ground for this project. Once all the posts and the bracing have been erected, the barbed wire is brought into the fold. The wire is wrapped around one corner post, using a staple to hold it at height, and then reeled out along the span of the fence. Then wrapped around the opposite corner post, pulled tight with a wire stretcher, and held in place with a few more staples. You repeat this process until you have 5 strands of barbed wire all up and down the fence. Then you attach the barbed wire to the T-posts using T-post clips, twisting them around and holding them firmly to the post. The sole purpose of the T-post is to keep the barbed wire strands spaced equally and off the ground. As with most fences, you need a gate to get in and out. And we found that we have a couple old steel gates, oddly enough, in the dump, to make a 20-foot double swing gate to give us access. These gates are mounted between 2 corner posts using leg screws. With the addition of the gates, our new fence is now complete. 1,000 feet of total fence, 13 wooden posts, over 100 T-posts, 5,000 feet of barbed wire, and a whole lot of sweat from me and Mitch have made a barrier to keep our new breeding heifers safe and sound during their stay in this pasture. Now, it's time to introduce them to their new home. All winter long, they have stayed in the corral, getting a bale of hay every few days to feed on. Now, they will be introduced to the lush pasture grasses and room to run. But first, we have to get them loaded in a trailer and moved. Cows never seem to want to go anywhere you want them to go. I wish you could just tell them how much more awesome their new home would be and convince them that they want to go. But when it comes down to it, you have to push them. And eventually, they are on a trailer. We travel with them to their new pasture and let them free.
Start to work becoming a working part of the ranch, getting pregnant and producing calves, and adding to the longevity of the ranch and our family. In the end, all the animals on the ranch are our responsibility. With or without a warrant, you protect your herd from danger, and sometimes that means fencing them out of an area that they'd like to explore. You get a few cuts, a few bruises, and you even drop a 30-pound piece of steel pipe on your foot, breaking your toe. But you also get to turn these guns loose. And I'd like to think that green grass makes the cow happy. I know it does me. Like it tell all. Please subscribe, like, comment, and share so that we can keep on bringing you videos like this one. You guys are amazing, and you keep us going, believe it or not. Your support has breathed new life into what we're doing, and you help us have the confidence and the energy to do all the new things and keep us going. So thank you for that. Have a great week, and thanks for joining me. Get on. Bye, everyone.